Justice Carpio, the Marcos administration, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in particular, repeatedly mentions that the Philippines will still resort to diplomatic channels, to diplomatic means of resolving tensions in the West Philippine Sea. But we all know what happened in the Ayungan Shoal during the Aquino administration. Would it be wise to still trust China at this point when it comes to actually doing good on their word?
Well, we've never trusted China because they engage all the time on double talk. But we should continue talking to them, but that is not the only recourse we can do. We can file an arbitration case. That's part of a peaceful settlement of dispute. That's allowed under the UN Charter. So we should use all of these courses of action. We should not be limited to just diplomatic talks.
Mm-hmm. Finally, Justice Carpio, time is of essence here because while the Philippines dilly-dallies on the filing of arbitration cases against China, Beijing continues to build up its assets in our own exclusive economic zone and in the rest of the South China Sea. Your final thoughts on what the Philippines can do to expedite the filing of these charges and including the buildup of its defense resources to be able to put a better stance or better chance against China?
Yes, we should all use all the possible means of defending our maritime zones, and one of those means is to file an arbitration case, a second arbitration case. We have not done that, and we just keep on talking to China, but China says one thing but does another thing on the ground and in the sea. So we have to do more than just having consultations with China, because China keeps on engaging in double talk. China always says, we will follow international law, we will abide with UNCLOS, but on the ground, they do not. They ram our vessels. It's very clear, they do not follow international law. We have to go to the tribunal already.
Right, and we will just have to wait and see on whether or not this administration would actually heed your nuggets of wisdom and pieces of advice. Thank you so much for joining us this morning, former Supreme Court Justice Antonio Carpio.
Thank you, Katrina.